Hey everyone, this is Abhirat Kaushik. Welcome to the sixth episode of Newell Society's Post-Placement Talks. Today, we have someone who is an electronics and communication engineer and who's done his minors in computer science and engineering. He passed out of PES in the year 2020 and is currently working as a full-stack engineering analyst at Accenture Hyderabad. So please welcome Pranav KB as today's guest. Hey Pranav.
Hi Abhirat, thank you for having me.
Yeah. I mean, so how's everything been? Like,
yeah, everything is going on good. Everything is work from home, so literally it's difficult to socialize with your colleagues, but going on well now. Yeah.
Right. So I mean, yeah, that's the situation for us as well. It's the same thing with our exams. There's a lot of uncertainty. Yeah.
So just we need to go on like this, so we can't help it. Yeah.
So, and have you gone to your office yet? Like you, I know you've got the job, but have you gone to your office yet?
No. I haven't even seen the building.
All right.
Just it's the online meeting. That's all.
All right. I'm sure you'll enjoy your time in the office as well.
Yeah.
So let's just start with what exactly is your role and responsibility as a full stack engineering analyst? Could you just explain about that?
Yeah. So like I joined Accenture as a full stack engineering analyst. So it's been around 7 months. And like my work is mainly with Microsoft Azure Cloud and also using the modern data platform for data processing, data transformation, data extraction, etc. And right. So like in general, my role is very similar to what we can call as a data engineer. And like, in action, I'm part of Avanade, like which is a company made in cooperation with Accenture and Microsoft. So in India, Avanade is 100% controlled by Accenture only. So it mainly does all the work based on Microsoft tools.
So okay, Microsoft tools, right?
Yeah. So Accenture in general uses various other tools, but in Avanade, we solve all the problems using Microsoft tools specifically.
Okay. So when exactly did you join Accenture?
So I joined Accenture in October 2020. So it's been around 7 months since I joined. Accenture had come for campus placements around August 10th and September 1st week. Also, they had come for two roles, ASC and FSC. I got FSC post, like, which is higher than ASC.
Right. Could you talk a little about your initial days as a software engineer? Like how were the initial days? How did you get used to your team or as such? Could you just talk about that?
Yeah. So before joining Accenture, they had given us pre-onboard learning courses. So which were about 300 hours of content. So only after finishing those 300 hours, all of us were given the joining date. So After joining, they had conducted one coding test as well as MCQ test. So based on this, again, they assigned us various roles in Accenture. So I got Cloud Native Azure. And like in initial days, like even after passing out from college, like even working, it felt like I'm still in college, I'm learning stuff. I'm still giving tests here and there.
Yeah.
So the learning still continues. Yeah.
Right. And how did you do? You, like, were you part of a team assigned to a specific task?
Yeah. So like after the test, which are conducted based on pre-onboarding courses, they allotted us to various domains. So I got allotted to Cloud Native Azure. So there were various other students from various other colleges all over India. So they were separated into various domains and they trained us on. They trained us specifically in this for about 11 weeks and then we were assigned to projects.
Right. And given the pandemic situation, what were the initial struggles which you faced or how was it different? Could you just talk about that a little?
Yeah. So like initially we need to communicate with our trainer or our manager. Like everything would be on, it's mainly on Microsoft Teams or any virtual communication platform. So you still don't know your manager, but still you are reporting to them.
Right.
So there was not much verbal communication or not much interaction which you can generally have personally. It felt like you're talking to someone you don't know just through a platform you're talking to them or reporting to them, etc.
Okay. So it took some time to get used to the platform, and now you're more or less, you've understood how it goes about.
Yeah.
Right. All right. So coming to the placement process of how you got this job, could you talk a little about the placement process and what were the key pointers in your resume which they looked at?
Okay, so the placement process, initially it was like they conducted one online test in college itself. It was a CBT. So the test had two parts. One was aptitude and other was coding. So after the students who had cleared these both tests, they called us for, it was like techno HR interview. So it was like, okay, in other companies, it's like two rounds of technical interview and one round of HR. So here it was like combination of one. So they asked questions based on my resume, my projects, and other my hobbies here and there. So like it was combination of both technical and HR.
Okay. What exactly did they look for in your resume, or what were the distinct factors in your resume?
So see, the resume must not be generic to all the companies. See, a company might come for a networking role, or some company might come for machine learning role. So you need to change company. You need to change the resume based on the company. You need to be specific. So even you might have 10 projects, like there might be various different domains. So what you need to do is, you see the job description. You just select 3 to 4 projects which are relevant to the job description of the company. So you should not keep generic all the projects. Like, so yeah, that's it. So even after that, whatever you keep in your resume, you should be very thorough about it. Like, even if they as basic thing, you should be able to answer. It should be very specific to the company. Yeah, mainly. Yeah.
Okay. Specific to each company. Right.
Yeah.
Okay, and could you talk a little about how projects, you know, research papers which we write, projects which we take up for internships, how important are they compared to the CGPA?
Okay, see, so we cannot streamline that one of them is important. See, if you see from placement perspective of you, CGPA is mainly like a cutoff for placements. So it generally ranges from 6.5 to 8.5 depending on the company. And 6.5 was the least set by our college placement central, so that we'll be eligible for placements. Right. And so if you see from other perspective, if you want to do higher studies, like, or even if you have plan of doing higher studies, if not immediately, maybe after 2 to 3 years, like GPA, research and internships are really important, because mainly they say universities select students based on these points, based on your research work done, based on your GPA. Mm-hmm. And even the internships, like, It should not be like generic anywhere. You just go, simply you learn what they do and you just come. It should be like you work on it. So you should have some information, like you should have some knowledge of what you have done. You should do something to the company. Like, those types of internships are really helpful.
Okay. And so
those are CGPA, even helpful for placements.
Right. So CGPA just acts as the cutoff. But after that, whatever adds value to your resume or application is the internships, research projects, and so on.
Yes, perfectly. Right. Yeah.
All right. Okay. And this is a fun kind of question. If you could do engineering again, could you just talk about what you would have done differently or what you might have improved upon?
Yeah. So like, really interesting question. Yeah. So I started coding really late. So what I suggest is to myself, if I do engineering again, so yeah, I would start coding maybe right after second year, like daily 1 hour is max. Like that's too much actually. So okay, what we do is just 2 months before placement, we start competitive coding. So I was good at generic coding, but competitive coding, which was like, you should be really specific. You need to clear the test cases with a very less time complexity and space complexity. So basically I'll learn all those concepts and be thorough about computer science concepts, because most of the companies which come to PS are software companies. So the ratio of even the ratio of student to company is really high with the competition too much in our college. So the coding and computer science concepts, I would have learned better if I do engineering again. Yeah.
And for a person who wants to start off with coding, could you suggest some resources or something which they might look into to start off?
Yeah, so if you are really new to the coding, you can start with Geeks for Geeks. So they start from basic of, if you want to learn a language just for placements, you can start with Python, because like in placements, you will get many string-based questions or substring matching, like many string-based questions, which are very easy to code in Python than C or Java, etc. So start with Python. You can start with Geeks for Geeks. You can learn the basics of Python. Then you can shift to HackerRank, so you can learn a little better way of coding. Then for competitive coding, you can try HackerRank and LeetCode to improve your competitive coding skills.
Right. And so we just have the last segment in our interview now. And this is the time where you can just give out some tips to your juniors on how they can do better or what they might have to look into.
Okay. So I suggest everyone, don't take placements very casually. So you might think like, okay, my seniors have all got placed, so there is almost everyone got placed, even I'll get placed. So this should not be the mindset. You should be clear about what you want, what type of company you want, like what type of role you want to go. And you should be thorough about coding itself, coding and other computer science concepts to clear the interviews for other software companies, etc. So just don't panic in the placement season, because your friends might get placed and you might be still sitting for companies. You might be getting rejected. Don't worry about it. Go with calm mind. Study properly, prepare individually for individual companies. So see the job description. You might have an idea like what they might ask or what role they might have come. So if company has come for a networking role, prepare computer networks concepts properly. So have preparation for individual subject, individual companies, and you focus on the company mainly.
All right, got it. So that's it from my side. Thanks a lot, Pranav, for this, for taking your time off for this interview.
Yeah, thanks, everybody. It was nice talking. Yeah.
And I'll see you again. I mean, I'll see you guys again in the next post-placement videos. And till then, please like, share, and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.